and good night to some of you. This is a very special broadcast, and of course, we must pray. And prayer we must, this very evening and always going forward. And I will pray in the language of heaven, because Chukwuka Abiyama is in control of all that we have been doing and will continue to do until Biafra is restored and all the suffering indigenous populations and the damnable zoological republic are set free. Chineke na nke pụrụ imenyere na Chukwuka Abiyama banyere na-efewo na aja aha nsọ ya mma mgbe niile. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya na-achị. Eluigwe na ụwa na-agba akaebe ịhụnanya gị na ebere gị amara gị na ọmịiko gị ebe ndị gị na-eze ebe dị ngọzi. Anyị wee na-eto gị, agbanyeghị atụmatụ ọjọọ niile nke ndị iro, iwe enye anyị ndụ ala nke dị n'ugboro n'ụbọchị nke taa. Anyị wee na-asị na ịja mma niile oto niile dịrị aha nsọ gị. Onye ọ bụ naanị aka ike niile na ọ gbadara aka ya. Anyị wee na-akpọku gị, na-asị gị na nke ọma anyị ga-ekele gị, nke ọjọọ ma anyị kelee gị. Anyị wee na-aja gị mma, wee na-eto gị, wee na-asọpụrụ gị. N'isi ụmụ gị niile bụ ndị ikwu ndị wee zoo oku mgbe a kpọrọ ha, ka ha wee chekwaa ala nsọ gị bụ Biafra onye nwụrụ na Chineke na ihe na ikpere anyị nkwa na omekataghị ka ndị iro wee were ala nsọ Biafra onye nwụrụ na Chineke na nke Benin Igwe. Agbanyeghị atụmatụ ọjọọ niile nke ndị iro ma ndị na-agba mkpọ bụ ebe niile dị iche iche onye nwụrụ na Chineke na ihere bụ nke niile etu a n'ụbọchị nke taa. Anyị wee na-eto gị, wee na-asị onye nwe anyị na Chineke na nke pụrụ m ihe niile. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya na-azọpụta, onye ọ bụ naanị ya bụ okwu ya niile bụ ihe na amen. Anyị wee na-asị ezi ebube dị ngọzi na otuto na ịja mma na nsọpụrụ site n'ebighiebi ma ruo n'ebighiebi. Ise, ise, ise.
Welcome, my amazing viewers. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so that you're notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you so much. And remember, in this channel, we do not preach hate speech. We are not talking down at anybody, not that I will preach against anybody, but we are saying the truth, bringing the plight of the people in the country called Nigeria to the world. It doesn't matter your tribe, it doesn't matter your religion. Every indigenous tribe in Nigeria is facing a difficult time. That is where we are aligned, bringing the problem to the front burner. The conventional media cannot tell us exactly what is the situation in Nigeria. They always try to play it down and give us wrong information. They don't let us know what is happening. But we must continue. It doesn't matter what they say. It doesn't matter what they do. We continue to bring the truth to the people. The truth and nothing but the truth. We can never tell lie about the situation. That is why we are here. Today we're going to talk about the situation of the southeastern part of Nigeria, the Biafra land. When I talk about southeast, I mean the old southeastern region, which is the today south-south and southeast. This is Biafra land. This very land is in occupation today. The Nigerian government is occupying this land, not just occupying the land, causing mayhem in that part of the world, creating problems, killing innocent people, killing innocent women and men in Biafra land. A lot is going on. Why are they killing the Biafrans? Simply because the Biafrans say that they do not want to be part of the corruption, part of the killings that are happening in the country of Nigeria. That they want their referendum. They want self-determination, which is a right of every human being, including in the law of Nigeria. It is enshrined in their law that self-determination can be pursued. The southeastern region, the Biafra people, are pursuing self-determination through a peaceful means. It has been so peaceful from the day one, since they have been pursuing this very freedom through the members of IPOB, the indigenous people of Biafra. They have not killed anybody. They have not committed any crime. They have not kidnapped anyone. They have not asked for ransom anywhere. All they are asking is a peaceful exit from the contraption called Nigeria, because Nigeria is a fraud. Nigeria is a fraud that they never signed into. A fraud that never do well to them, a place where there is so hatred, they are so much hated that they don't want to be part of that very contraption anymore, and they are asking for a referendum to grant them their freedom. Conduct a referendum for the Biafran so that you can know what is actually in their mind. If you think it's not only Biafrans that are asking for freedom, why not conduct the referendum? That is what the Biafrans are asking for. And I hope that very soon that referendum will happen. It doesn't matter what they do, it doesn't matter what they say. Already we are conducting the referendum on our own. If you watch from the seat at home that is being held in the southeastern region in Biafra land, you can see that the compliance is 99%. The compliance of the seat at home is 99%. What does that show you? That shows you that the masses are speaking in one voice with IPOB under the leadership of Mazin Nandekan. They are speaking in one voice, saying that they do not want to be a part of this very contraption. And most importantly, asking for the immediate release of our Supreme Leader Mazin Nandekan, who they have captured, taking him into custody. He was being kidnapped from Kenya and sent to Nigeria through extraordinary rendition. He was never arrested. It was a kidnap. Even Kenya government denied. They haven't up to today. They have not made a statement to show us that they were involved. But we have every evidence to show that he was kidnapped in Kenya, because his passport says so. And he was having a British passport, not Nigerian passport. He's a British citizen, not a Nigerian citizen. He's a British citizen and a Biafran citizen. He was kidnapped from Kenya and sent to Nigeria to be tormented, to be suffered. But we said no to that. We can't agree to that. That is more reason why Biafrans are sitting at home every Monday. Every Monday, Biafrans are sitting at home to air their opinion. And tomorrow is another Monday. Many Biafrans are going to sit at home again. And those who have not joined can join. It's something you can do to show your own, to pay your own dues, to show your own disapproval of what is happening in the Catalonia of Nigeria. That is why people are sitting at home. Tomorrow is going to be another sit at home. If you have not joined, join the sit at home. This is the only way we can be able to say that we are not part of that very Catalonia of Nigeria. The only way we can be able to air our opinion. The only way we can be able to show our grievances. You know, the Biafrans cannot protest outside. You can't protest. And if we do not have this very sit at home, who knows what will be happening to Asuda Mazinakan by now. But because of the sit at home, the world are hearing us. They know that we stand together with Asuda Mazinakan. And even the government of Nigeria knows that we are standing together with Mazinakan. Mazinakan is not alone. He is not alone. He is with every Biafran. We are praying and calling for his immediate release. It doesn't matter what anybody say. It doesn't matter what they think. All we want is the release and immediate release of Asuda Mazin Nandekan. They are coming with different kinds of propaganda. Propaganda from east, west, north and south. Different kind of propaganda. You have seen that when the Biafrans also talked about election. Biafrans said they do not want to participate in the election anymore. Because of that, today you can see that the government controlled by the Janjaweed has now pushed on the Akida squad to the southeastern region. You may be hearing of killing every now and again. The killing is being done by the government of Nigeria. They have done it so many times that this is not the first time they are doing that killing. But they just want to do it to make sure that they demoralize the people of the southeast. Make sure they threaten us and put fear in our mind. Make sure that people stop associating with the IPOB and also stop supporting the ESN. They begin to peddle lies that the ESN are killing Igbos, that Igbos are killing themselves. This is the lie they always push over. This is a lie they have been selling from the day one. You see them, some people, they come online and tell you that Igbos don't love themselves, Igbos don't have leader, Igbos don't do this. But the actual truth is that Igbos have leaders who are responsible. You cannot be a leader of Igbos just because you call yourself a leader or just because you are appointed in a post. You have to prove yourself, show yourself approved before we can take you as a leader. As today, the leader we have in the southeastern region is our Supreme Leader Mazin Nandekan, who has proven himself from all angles, from all sections, to show the people that he is right in what he's doing. He can never betray Biafra. He has never done it. He swore to it to defend Biafra and defend every Biafra. And that is exactly what he is doing. He has sacrificed everything sacrificable, including his own family, including his own parents. And yet, he is fighting for you and I. Why won't we stand along with him? Why would anybody in his right sense be talking down on something that is going to give the man that is fighting for you a freedom? When you know that the freedom of Asuda Mazin Nandekan is the freedom of Biafra. If Mazin Nandekan is free today, Biafra will be free. That is the obvious truth. It doesn't matter what anybody say. It doesn't matter the propaganda they push. We know the truth, and the truth has so set us free. Contraption called Nigeria do not want truth. They never promote truth, and they never want the truth. That is why Mazi Nnamdi have used truth to destroy that very contract called Nigeria. He never fired a shot. The only weapon that our student Mazi Nnamdi used against the Nigeria is truth and his microphone. That is why today, every single soul in the contraption called Nigeria is awake and they are asking for what is right. The propaganda they are pushing forward. If you are from the southern region, do not listen to them and do not join them in that propaganda saying that Igbos are killing themselves. Igbos are not killing themselves. They have never been killing themselves. They have never done so. Igbos are the most peaceful people you can have in that country called Nigeria. And the southern region is the most peaceful region in that very country called Nigeria. The only thing that is happening is that the DSS are the one causing the mayhem in the southeastern region. They have employed an unknown government that they have been using in several other places to kill people. They have now pushed them down to Anambra State because we say we will not participate in the election in Anambra State. They push them down to Anambra State to begin to disorganize and kill people. If you want to stay safe, stay away from anything that has to do with the election. Stay away from anything that has to do with the election. If you have your families back home, if you're not in Nigeria, you're outside, call your people in Anambra State. Tell them, stay away with anything that has to do with the election. Any vehicle or instrument that have the emblem of a political party, do not use it. If you use it, you're exposing yourself to death. You're exposing yourself to death, and the DSS are already on ground, searching for people like you to kill. So, if you want to stay alive, stay away from anything that has to do with any political party or their symbol. Do not talk about election in Anambra State. If you do, you are risking your own life. May Chukwu Okike be my guide and protect us and direct us, show us the way to follow. We will continue to pray for our sister Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, knowing fully well that very, very soon he's going to be out. It doesn't matter what the enemy said. It doesn't matter what the enemy are doing. He will surely join us very soon because he is our leader. He has appointed by Chukwu Okike Abiam, and he took up the appointment. And since then, he has been working towards the freedom of Biafra, and he will continue to do so. We will continue to pray for Asin Amazin Nani Kano and listen to his messages. Listen to every message you can lay your hand upon that is left behind by Asin Amazin Nani Kano. There are so many informations in those messages. That is why now I will play a message of Asin Amazin Nani Kano. I will play a message of our Supreme Leader Amazin Nani Kano to you so that you can listen and hear what he has for us. Let us hear from Asin Amazin Nani Kano once again. His Excellency, Amazin Nani Kano.
Okay. We have somebody on the phone. This is Radio Biafra. You have the honor of being our first caller. You must give us your name and where you are, because this is Radio Biafra.
Hello.
Yes, your name and where you are, please.
My name is Michael.
Michael who?
London.
Michael who? What is your surname?
Michael KK.
From London. Please go ahead. This is Radio Biafra. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm just listening to your news or your broadcast. It's very interesting. I just want to find out what exactly are you talking about?
What is your surname?
Okeke.
Have you heard of Biafra before?
Yes.
How many years ago did you hear about Biafra?
So many years ago, up to 10 years ago.
What does Biafra mean to you? When you hear the word Biafra, what does it mean to you? When you hear Biafra, what does it mean to you, the word Biafra? What does it mean to you?
That's why I called you, to find out from you, because you're the one saying it, so I'll be able to get a better picture of what you're talking about. Yeah. Anyway, sir, I just want to keep you one or two things. I think the best way, where are you? Are you in London? I know you are in London, because that's why I called you. You want us to listen to you properly, you go to Nigeria and start doing this. You understand what I mean? You are the people causing trouble for Nigeria. What are you talking about? Blah, blah, blah. You understand? I don't understand what you're talking about. Go to Nigeria and start doing this thing so we'll be able to hear you properly. Stop deceiving people is not going to deceive people. Are you hearing me?
I'm listening to you when you finish there. If you have any question to ask me, you ask me that, I ask you a question.
Yeah, the question I'm asking you is, yes. If you witness Biafra war, I don't think you'll be saying this, what our people go through. So please, don't push people to go and fight war. Don't make people to go and start doing things that they're not supposed to do. If you know you want to fight about Biafra, go back to Nigeria and start doing it there. Stop doing it in London. Stop coming here and hide and start doing it in London.
Okay.
Start doing it there so they'll listen to you properly.
Thank you. Have you finished so I can ask you some questions? Have you finished?
Yeah, finished.
When did you start following Radio Biafra?
Not quite long.
No wonder. Because if you had followed Radio Biafra, you will know that I went to Nigeria and I broadcasted from the zoo, from the heart of darkness, Lagos, where we are on 88.2 FM broadcasting live in Lagos. I have been to Biafra land to broadcast. I have broadcasted everywhere I have been to, and we are going back home. In case you don't quite follow, we have purchased our transmitter and we are going home to broadcast from home. I have been there.
Let me finish.
I need to finish what I'm saying.
Okay.
I didn't interrupt you. You will not interrupt me. We have broadcasted from home. I have preached Biafra on the streets of Lagos. I have preached Biafra at the airport in Lagos. The reason why we are here is because in that useless contraption, there is no light. In that useless contraption called the Zoological Republic of Nigeria, they do not have ordinary broadband strong enough to carry our signal. That is why we are here. We are not here out of choice. The same way that you're in London. You're in London because there's no running water in your village. You are in London because there is no light. You are in London because there is no work where you come from. That's why you're here. And do you know those that fought for London? Do you know that Hitler came to this country and destroyed it completely? Do you know that Churchill did not surrender? Do you know they did not give up despite the damage to the people? Something comparable to what you saw in the war. And do you also know, my dear brother, that the name you answer is Okeke? Do you know the meaning of your name? What is the meaning of your name?
That's not the issue.
No, what is the meaning of your name? If you can't answer, it means you're a baby. What is the meaning of your name?
Well, you can't. That's not the issue. Well, I want to put two things to you, sir. Only two things.
Where is your village? Which village do you come from? Where is your village? Where is your village?
Just wait. I'll tell you my village. I want to say two things. The two things I want to put to you is, one, if at the end of the day, that what you are doing, that you are strongly believe on it.
I'm listening to you, my dear brother. Go ahead.
If at the end of the day, that what you are doing is that you are solely believe, that you are solely believe on it, that at the end of the day, you will not do like Owazurike, maybe they'll give you some political appointment, you'll just be quiet. I will support you.
Now you are talking. Like, that's what you should have said. Now you are talking properly. Now you are beginning to speak. Go ahead.
My second one again is, Biafra is not our problem. Our problem is our leader. Every Nigerian is corrupt. Every Nigerian wants to loot. Nobody wants to help in Nigeria. So that is the problem we are facing now. Not sharing the country. Nigerians need to change. We need to change our way. We need to behave like the Western world. Thank God you are here. You see what people are doing here. Then we go and suffer for money. I'll take the whole country. But every Nigerian wants to loot and come and put the money here. So if you can talk about that, let us change our way, our thinking. It will be okay, sir. Thank you very much.
No, don't go away. Maybe you're on contract, so you can call any line for long. Stay where you are. I will answer your questions before you go away. Do you see this Biafra that we are pursuing? Biafra cannot come unless we are honest people, so accept what you're saying. I said in Germany, and I repeated the same thing yesterday. Before we came, there were no people like us. After we are gone, there will be none like us. Nobody is more committed. Nobody is more into Biafra. Nobody has sacrificed more, I put it that way, in this very cause than those surrounding Radio Biafra. I make it very clear to you that what we do is not that we may become known or popular or get money nonsense. We are doing this because God himself, Tukwu Abiyama, has determined that we should come to do it. We cannot be anybody comparing us to any other person insults to me. Those people are not fit to be called dear friends. I will no longer mention them by name in 2014, that they are not worthy to be called dear friends. By their fruits you shall know them. I have not failed my people before. I don't intend to fail them in the future. And any day I contemplate, God to them as my witness, any day I dream, I contemplate selling my people out, if God does not destroy me and my family, I will know he's not God. He is no longer God. If God does not destroy me, any single day I dream, I did not say I will do. I said if I dream, if I think about it, if God doesn't destroy me and my household, I will know He is not God.
Anyway, what will happen is that I will not today. Because if at the end of the day, or later they will not call you and give you one position in Nigeria, you just keep quiet. That is what needs to betray us. But if you are strong enough to do this, not to push us at the end, you will just go away. If you are strong enough, come up behind you. But make sure what you are saying, what you are doing, or what you are trying to do, that you are a man of faith, man that will carry on. Not be talking, because what you find out now, we are not more equipped. What you find out now is that most Nigerians, if you want to make money, just spring up from nowhere. From the north, you say you are Boko Haram. From the east, you say you are Blatter. From this side, you say you are this. And the government will call you and compensate you. Keep quiet. We know that at all. We don't even know what you are doing. What is your own plan? But we pray that your plan should be, and you want to bring this thing to Roma. But what I'm trying to say is that sharing the country, it will not save us.
It will save us.
We are greedy.
No, my dear brother, do you know why you are greedy? Do you know why we are greedy? Do you know why?
I don't know, tell me, sir.
You sound like an educated man. You know you live in England, is that correct?
Yes.
Would you like to see the Taliban moving from Kandahar in Afghanistan close to where you are?
No.
Then, do you know that the northern part of the zoo we call Nigeria, that their behavior, their religion, their conduct, their Sharia is the same thing as the Taliban in Afghanistan? Do you know that?
Mm-hmm.
Then why do you want us to be in the same country with them? If you don't want them to be in sorry, why would you want them to be in the same country with us? Do you see my problem, my dear brother? There is one thing that defines who forms a country with you. It is called value system. The same way you think is the same way I think when it comes to economic problems, to social problems, and to politics. You cannot have people in the same country. One is Sharia, they cut off your hand. The other side, they're claiming you're secular. It has never worked anywhere in the world. There has to be one overarching legal system, one overarching political system, one value system that governs the life of the people within that country. I am an educated man. I went to school. That's what I was taught in school. For goodness sake, no country on this earth can accommodate three divergent value systems. It has never worked anywhere on the planet. Never. Nowhere on this earth has it worked. If you don't want Taliban close to you, close to your house, taking your little child, raping her at the age of six, then why should I live with them in my country? I don't want them, and I cannot have them. We are pursuing Biafra. I like the doubts that people have against us. We are going to prove them wrong. That's all I have to say. Thank you very much.
After listening to his voice, I must tell you, myself in particular, I'm energized and I'm strengthened more than ever. And I hope you are. We will continue to work for our freedom. No man born of a woman can take our freedom from us. It doesn't matter what they do. It doesn't matter what they say. They will kill us. We will kill them. At the end of the day, Biafra will come. Nechukwu Okikabia, my guide and protector, was supreme leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Nechukwu Okikabia will continue to protect Mazi Nnamdi Kanu wherever he is. Give him strength. Give him good health. Give him more revelation so that he can lead us to the promised land very soon. Thank you so much for watching and remain blessed. Bye-bye. See you again on the next video.